Hello, it's time for a new tutorial about game for automation. So today I would like to show you some new stuff, tips and tricks, and a collection of things which you should know about game for automation. So first of all, what we see in here, this quick edit window, it's new in the latest releases. You can turn it on with F1. And the setting how to turn it on is here under Game for Automation controller. You can assign here a hotkey for the quick edit. So the quick edit is always reacting on the things you are selected. So for example, I can create here an empty game object. I can add, for example, a drive. And after I added a drive, I will have all the behavior models for drives. So for example, let's add a simple drive. So you've got the most important game for automation functions here in the quick edit window available. You can turn it off with F1. The quick edit window changes its functions when you are starting the simulation, and now you are able, for example, to increase the time scale, so to speed up the simulation, or to increase the speed of the drives with a speed override. You could also jog the drive axis if you would like to. And by putting in here a name, you could even filter your drives. If you're starting the simulation and if you're in standard settings, usually the game window is automatically displayed. So in the game window, you are having this info box, and in all the game windows, if you insert the game for automation controller, and if you prevent this info box for being shown, you can select here in the game for automation controller hide info box. When turning now the simulation on, you will see no more info box is shown. Sometimes I prefer to put the game window down here, very small, because usually I'm working only in the scene view. And now by turning on and off the simulation, the game window won't overlay the scene window. If you encounter problems in your editor, so maybe Unity is getting very slow in the edit mode, you could try in selecting game for automation and here reset hierarchy view. This might help you. Also, if you don't have the standard game for automation layers or something went wrong when you first installed game for automation, you might have here an error in the console and you first need to get rid of the error. So then maybe the standard settings are not set it. So you might see it if the game for automation layers are not here, then you should select game for automation, apply standard settings. This will set you all the standard settings inside of Unity you will need to use a game for automation. Sometimes if your Unity behaves strange and you might not get rid of some errors that are shown here, a good tip would be to delete your library folder. So basically the library folder is not needed. It's just a temporary folder which is created automatically by Unity whenever it not exists. So if you encounter any strange problems, close Unity, delete completely this library folder, so you can delete it completely, not only the content, delete it completely and restart Unity. The library folder will be recreated automatically. In bigger problems, the performance of the visualization might be very important. And one thing you should do, everything what's not moving in your model should be set to static. Whereas everything what needs to move, like for example, this gantry axis, needs to be non-static here, so you need to turn static off. That's very important to set the parts which are not moving to static for the performance improvements of your model. In the latest release, we implemented additional functions for gripping. You can open a gripping demo model by additional demos gripping. And in this demo model, you will see some examples how you could do gripping. So I'm going to start it. And basically you see three kinds of gripping. The demo 2 here shows you the classical gripping with the grip script, the fingers moved by drives and gears. So that's how it is usually has been done before the latest release. Here in the demo 0A, we are showing you a simplified way for gripping. So here we are having just a gripper script attached, and the gripper script will move if it's pointing to the fingers, automatically fingers. It will generate automatically the needed grip script. So nothing needs to be added to your model besides the kinematic, and based on the width and offset here, it will also generate you automatically a sensor, a raycast sensor for detecting the parts to be gripped. And the biggest advantage here is that the gripper is not closing more than the size of the part. So the closing will automatically be stopped when the part is touched. And you get on the signals of the gripper here also signals for fully opened or fully closed. So for example, when a part is gripped, the fully closed signal won't be turned on. If we don't reference fingers in our gripper script, automatically a raycast sensor will be created and the gripper will grip without moving any kind of fingers just after the closing or the opening time is finished. The part will be released. As you see here in demo 2, it's always possible to interchange parts between grippers. So as soon as one new gripper is gripping a part, it will be automatically released from the old gripper. We see here in demo 1A another example. Here we have a new component which is called Fixer. And the Fixer is basically like, I would say, a gluing component. So as soon as a part is entering the Fixer and the gripper is opened, it will be glued to the position. And you can glue multiple parts in here. So it's a good way for placing parts on other parts, for placing parts in a rack or something like that. So every time you want a part, a MU, to be moved after placing it, fix it with a fixer and it will automatically be fixed. Demo 1B also shows another way for the fixer. So here the fixer, let's check where it is. Here the fixer is using raycast. So we are defining use raycast and a raycast direction and raycast layers. So you don't need to have a box collider on the fixer. You could also use a line with a raycast for fixing parts to the fixer. That's all for today. See you next time in our next tutorial. Bye bye.